Welcome back to the another video of Power BI. Today our topic is we will create one table with the few KPI card where we will be showing day wise order quantity, shipping quantity and delivery quantity, and then we will create two more KPI to show the difference between total delivery quantity and then again we will create three more KPI to show the sum of delivery quantity, order quantity and shipping quantity. One of our subscriber has shared with us this data, and as you can see here, this is we are making a video. Like for example, day one, if I select, so the old KPI got changing. See, so you can see the all the difference between sum of delivery quantity and order quantity and shipping quantity, the order deliver and differences. You will see like that. Okay, so like that we have all the days 1 to 31. So without any further delay, let's get it started. All right, so as you can see here, we have uploaded our data, the total three data in the Power BI. Okay, then what we will do, first we will create one bridge table. Okay, just click on any table. From here just go to the new tab and you have to type the measure table. This table is equal to calendar, auto we will use, and we will close with the bracket. Oh sorry, it was something, yeah. Okay, and we will commit it. Okay, after creating a bridge table, we will just drag one table over here and I will select here the day. From the hierarchy we will select the day, from each column, sorry, from the each table we will select their quantity. Okay, as you can see here, I will select the quantity for each column. All right, so but there is a one problem over here. Can you see this? It's showing the total quantity here because we don't have, why it's showing? Because we didn't create any relationship between this table with we have created. To create a relationship, I hope everybody has idea that how we can create a relationship. To create a relationship, just go to the, okay, after click on manage relationship, click on new, and from here we will select first table our delivery info, and then we will select this table, from here delivery and the delivery day. Okay, and after that just click OK. And like that we have to create new relationship. Again, what I will do, I will select the order info and bridge table, and we will select the date. Okay, just click OK. Then again we have to create one more relationship. You can select the ship info and we will create bridge table, and then select the both column and click OK. Okay, and after that just close it. After creating a relationship, if you go back to the data view, you'll see the all table has been created over here. Okay, now our first part is done. Now what we have to do, as you can see here, now our table is successfully created. Okay, don't change relationship to the both, otherwise it will shut off. Okay, just keep it single. Okay, after creating a table, now what we will do, I will just go back to the menu. From here I will select first one new KPI. You can, oh sorry, I'm so sorry. Okay, I will just go back and I will select one KPI from there. Okay, in this KPI, first what I will do, I will take all the quantity. Like first I will take the delivery quantity, then I will take the order quantity, and then I will take the shipping quantity. So like that you will get your all quantity, sum of delivery quantity, order quantity, and like that you will get everything. Okay, now you have your all the quantity, but now we want to show the difference between these all quantity, like, you know, or total order quantity and difference, right? Now for that we have to create two more measure. To create two more measure, what I will do, first you can use the quick measure also, and you can use the new measure also. It's all up to you. If you want to use quick measure, use it quick measure. Otherwise, quick measure you can use it from here. But I prepare new measure. I will click on the new measure. I will write here the DAX. I will click on here. I will give the name of this. You can give as per your choice. You can write quantity and delivery. That was our question, right? Delivered quantity. Okay, then we will write is equal to sum of, in the sum what I will write, we will not use here the, we will write here order quantity. See, this one we have to select. Make sure whenever you are selecting the quantity, your column name and the tables are perfectly fine. Okay, and we will close this bracket. I will write minus, then again I will do sum of delivered quantity. So you can select from here also directly delivery info and delivery quantity. I will close the bracket, hit enter, and you will see here one more column has been created. Okay, I will just go back here. I will select one more KPI, new KPI card, and here I will select that new measure which we have created just now, right? This one we created or this one. Okay, I will select this. Okay, now our first KPI has been created. Now there is one more measure we will calculate. I will just go to the new measure, and you can use the quick measure also to use a difference. Okay, to create a differences, I will name this measure as a difference between both tables, right? Difference, I will write is equal to sum, and oh sorry, this rest table has been, okay, I will write here order info. Order info from the quantity we want here, right? Then I will close this. I will minus with sum of quantity. Okay, this was our question, right? Because we have to show the difference between now I will just click on here, and it will give us here only, and now it will show us the difference between both the order quantity and delivery quantity versus shipping quantity difference. Okay, so like that you can create two more KPI. Now if you will see here, if you will click on any, now if you will click anywhere, you will see the day wise everything has been created. Okay, now there is a, it's changing, right? So you can say day 7, where is the, what is the difference and what is the total quantity, like that you can check out. Okay, so I hope this answer will satisfy your question, and till then, happy learning, keep supporting, don't forget to subscribe my channel, and